In this lecture, we will talk about what is arthritis, what are the common types of arthritis, how can we differentiate between these forms of arthritis. Hi, I'm Dr. Girnita, or you can call me Dr. G. If you are suffering from arthritis, autoimmune diseases, or you are looking to prevent those diseases and improve your quality of life, hit the button below to subscribe to my channel.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
It is estimated that 52 million people in the United States suffer from arthritis. What is arthritis? Arthritis is a general term derived from the Greek words arthro, which means joint, and itis, which means inflammation. Arthritis is a disease of the joints and spine. People that suffer from arthritis, most commonly, they will have pain and tenderness, which is pain with palpation, swelling, stiffness, worms, as well as difficulties using their joints. Let's say grabbing a fork, or walking, or bending. Arthritis can affect young adults, but also elderly adults. Although there are many causes of arthritis, the result is the same. The joint cartilage, which is the part that covers the bone, gets slowly destroyed, and that will cause pain, difficulties to walk, and also will result in a lower quality of life. What are the most common types of arthritis? There are many types of arthritis. In rheumatology, we look at arthritis as being degenerative, or as we call it, wear and tear, or inflammatory. The degenerative arthritis, we call it osteoarthritis. Osteoarthritis is a type of arthritis that we mostly develop in life as we overuse our joints. Like the tires of your car, because you overuse them, your joints will develop wear and tear. On the other hand, inflammatory arthritis is usually a disease that affects the young adults, but sometimes not only young adults. The major causes of inflammatory arthritis are, number one, autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, ankylosing spondylitis, and lupus. Number two, crystal-induced arthritis like gout or pseudogout. In all these cases, the chronic and excessive inflammation will cause destruction of the joints and will lead to loss of function and, as I said, poor quality of life. The third type of arthritis is called reactive arthritis. Reactive arthritis is usually triggered by 1 to 4 weeks after an infection. Most common infections that trigger reactive arthritis originate in the gut or urinary tract infection. Infections like hepatitis B, C, HIV, or even a tick bite can induce reactive arthritis. Usually, treating the cause of the infection will rapidly improve the arthritis symptoms. How can we differentiate between these forms of arthritis? In rheumatology, we take a very detailed clinical history, and we will also make a physical exam. We look for a few important aspects. How did the pain start? What joints were affected? If there is swelling, stiffness, associated with this joint pain, if the patient has morning stiffness, how long is the stiffness lasting? We look to see, or we try to see, if stiffness is improving with movement or not. Now let's compare osteoarthritis with rheumatoid arthritis. Rheumatoid arthritis is a type of inflammatory arthritis. Inflammatory arthritis, as I said, usually affects young adults, while on the other hand, osteoarthritis affects people that are more advanced in age. Patients with inflammatory arthritis will always present with swollen, painful, stiff joints, and they will also have significant morning stiffness that will last more than 1 hour. On the other hand, people with osteoarthritis, they have less swelling, they have less stiffness, and that will last usually under 30 minutes. Patients with inflammatory arthritis and morning stiffness will improve with movement, while patients with osteoarthritis will not improve with movement. Actually, movement will make it worse. In patients with inflammatory arthritis, the progression of the disease is very rapid, and that will cause destruction of the joints. While on the other hand, in osteoarthritis, the disease is more slow, progresses more slower, and the destruction is not so massive. If you have any of these symptoms, I strongly recommend you to be evaluated by a physician that will provide you with an accurate diagnosis and treatment. If you are looking to prevent those diseases and improve your quality of life, don't forget to hit the button below to subscribe to my channel. Please share this video with people that you know are suffering. Thank you for watching. See you soon.